Hello everyone, Kalyan from Blackbox Tech. In today's episode, I will take you through the process of creating your own schematics. So, what is schematics? As per documentation, schematic is a workflow tool for the modern web. It can apply transform to your project, such as creating a new component or updating your code. A good example could be Angular CLI, by which you can create, update, and perform different tasks with some commands. This tutorial is divided in three parts. First, I will go through the logger modules I have created and published in NPM. Second, I will go through the detail of schematics where I will show you how to create your own custom schematics. And the third, we will try out the same schematics in our Angular Universal project. So without any further ado, let's get started. In my Visual Studio workspace, I have added three projects. I will start with the logger module. This is a simple TypeScript project with a main index.ts file which holds all the main module code of the logger. Package.json having all the dependencies of this module. TSConfig.json holds the configuration where I have defined the output directory which will hold the build output. In index.ts, I have required all the files, mainly Winston as a logger library, and configured the transport, and at last I have exported it as logger to be used in our Angular Universal project. In package.json, I have added a build script which will transpile TypeScript to JavaScript and send the artifacts to logger directory. When I will publish it using npm publish, the prepare script will trigger which will build the project before publishing. I have already published it and you can see it in npmjs.com. So now think what we are trying to achieve by the schematics. So this should do two things. One, it should install the logger module from npm and the entry in our package.json. Second, it should create a server.ts with required configuration which include a logger file entry. So let's create a schematic. So the first thing you have to do is to install the schematic CLI by using this command. I have already installed it, so let's move into the next part. To generate a blank schematic project, you need to run this command where name is the schematic's name and you can add anything you want. Once it's done, let's check what all files it's created for you. The source directory holds two main things. One is the schematic directory and a collection.json. As we want our schematic to work with ng add command, let's rename our schematics to ng-add. The schematic folder contains the main entry point index.ts and a spec file for testing. In collection.json, the first line defines the main schematic collection path. We'll also change our schematic name here as ng-add. You can add your description here, and the factory property contains a string which references the main index.ts file with the main function within the hash. Now let's move into the schematics I've already generated. In this, I've also renamed the folder as ng-add, and within this folder, I have the main entry point index.ts. As I said earlier, the first thing we want is to add our logger module from npm and install it. So this function serves that purpose. We are performing two tasks within this function. One is adding our logger module entry in package.json and then installing the modules. The first thing to check if the package.json exists within the tree. Afterwards, I am reading the JSON and parsing. Within the package.json, I am checking if the dependency block is available. If not, then create it. And I am also adding entry for our logger module within that. We are also overwriting our existing package.json with the updated data. At last, I am installing node modules using node package install task method. We also want a new file to be added within our SSR project, and the file name is server.ts. We have created a folder called files for that purpose. Now, within the main entry point function, I am chaining two different tasks as function which will execute in sequence. First, it will run our @package function, and then it will take our server.ts from files directory and merge within the workspace. Our package.json is pretty straightforward. I have added a simple build script which will use TSC to compile TypeScript to JavaScript. So let's build that using npm run build command. To test a schematic locally, you can run this command. Please note, during development, schematic by default run with dry run flag, which means it will not actually create any file in the file system. But you can disable that using --dry-run equal to false flag. I have already published this schematic in npm. So now let's use this in a real project environment. I have switched to our Angular project where we don't have an Express server. Our node logger comes with a complete Express server. Now, if we type ng add @blackboxtext/logger, you can see it will automatically install the required dependencies and also create a file called server.ts. Now, let's start the application to see it working. Once the server starts, you can see our default console is visible, which is coming from our server file. And if you load the browser, our logger will also stream the request response logs in console as well as inside the log folder within our project.